Hello students, welcome to our online class. Today we can see mathematics. Before getting into the class, see the interesting story in the video clip.
The name of the story is Clever Fish. One day, a fisherman was fishing to a river as usual. He threw his net into the river and he just sat waiting there for fish to get in so that he could sell a lot of fish in the market and get some good money out of it. After some time, fisherman heard some rustle and bustle in the net, thinking that he must have got a lot of fish in the net. He actually took out the net out of water. But then, to his dismay, he saw just one tiny little fish in that net. He grabbed hold of that fish, but then suddenly the fish started talking to him. Tiny little fish said to the fisherman,
"Oh, fisherman, please, please leave me. Please leave me. Otherwise, I will die. I will die out of water."
But fisherman did not give any attention to the request of the fish. But then, again, that tiny little fish said to the fisherman,
"Oh, fisherman, I will tell you something which is of your help. If you leave me back in water, I will tell all my friends about you and I will bring them near to the bank of river so that when you come next time, you will have much more fish."
Fisherman thought to himself,
"Wow, that's not a bad deal at all."
He was thinking,
"If I let go one tiny little fish today, tomorrow I will get a lot of more fish, because this tiny little fish will bring all his friends to me."
Believing the word of this tiny little fish, fisherman let go this tiny little fish into the river again. This tiny little fish was really happy and it swam away happily into the river, never to come back. Poor fisherman. He came next day expecting that there will be a lot of fish that this tiny little fish would bring. But that tiny little fish was very clever, and because of his cleverness, he saved his life from this fisherman. So, children, moral of the story is, you have to be really, really clever to save your life from such challenging moments.
Hope you have enjoyed the video clip. Now, tell me students, what you have understood by seeing this video? Well, it's all about fish. So, my today's topic is chapter 1, The Fish Tale. Now, tell me students, do you know any poems about fish? You just think and discuss with your friends. So, here are some drawings. Drawing fishes are made by children. Here is one drawing which is made by Naveta of class 1. This is another one made by Maya of class 4. Okay, these are all few drawings. So, when you think of fish, what shapes come to your mind? It may be triangle or square, or this kind of shape may come into your mind. Now, this is an activity in which you need to try to use a square and a triangle to draw a fish. Now, we will try this. We need to use squares and triangles. Let this be one square. This be a triangle. And this be another triangle. Then we have one small triangle over here and one more smaller triangle over here. This somewhat looks like a fish. So, in similar manner, you can also try to make fish using squares and triangles. Now, we move on to next page. So, here Meenakshi is a girl whose eyes look like a fish. So, can you think of someone who has such eyes? Just try, draw a face with fish eyes. So, fishes can have very different sizes. The small fish is about 1 cm long. How long is the biggest fish, can you imagine? So, in this chapter, we are going to see in mathematical wise multiplication, division, shapes and measurements. Here is one question. How many times longer is your big fish than the smallest fish? If we talk of 2 meter, 2 meter equal to 200 centimeter, okay? And the smallest fish was only 1 centimeter. So, larger fish is 200 times larger than the smallest fish. Got it? Now, here it is written, the biggest fish in the world is whale shark. It is actually not a whale. You all must heard about whale, but it is a big, big fish. When we talk about whales, they are different from fish. They are actually mammals. One whale shark was long as 18 meters. Just think how long that it is. Almost 12 children of your size standing one on top of the other. And guess what it weighed? Well, much, much more than what 12 of you together weighed. Its weight was about 16,000 kg. See this page. Here are some questions. About how many kilograms do you weigh? Let's suppose 40 kg be the answer to this. The next question is, so 12 children like you put together will weight about, well, multiply 40 into 12. This will be 480 kgs. So, 480 kgs will be the answer over here. See the next question. About how much more does the whale shark weigh than 12 children like you put together? So, the weight of the whale shark was 16,000 kgs. So, we need to divide it by 480 to get this answer. Do the division and fill the answer in the third blank. Now, it's time for work, students. Here I have given two activities. The first one is, try to use a square and a triangle to draw a fish. The next one is, draw a face with fish eyes. So, you have to draw the face. The eyes should be look like fish. These two activity, you have to do it in your classwork. So, you have the sideway note for mathematics, right? You have to draw these two activity in your classwork. Okay, students, I'll catch you with another session by continuing this chapter. Thank you.